guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. My name's Crystal and today we are going to go through my hygiene kit. I have uploaded a video on my channel of my makeup kit. That had a lot of positive reviews from you guys, and that particular bag that I use as my main travel case, the Atoll Collective bag, that is actually in conjunction with this bag. So this one here is also by Atoll Collective and it contains all of my hygiene stuff that I take with me to go and see my clients either on set at their wedding or in a studio or wherever it is that they want their makeup done. I take this with me everywhere and it is essential that this comes with me no matter where I go. So before we jump into the video, do not forget to subscribe to my channel if you like my videos, if you like me, and also do not forget to go and check me out on my Instagram as well. I will have my handle on the screen for you guys to go and check me out, and I will also have it in the description box below. Again, do not forget to subscribe before you leave, and without further ado, let's just get straight into the video. Okay, so as I've said, this bag is by Atoll Collective. It is super sturdy. It's got like a hard top on it and hard exteriors on it as well. It comes with a top handle and then it also has a shoulder strap here as well, which comes in handy so much, you have no idea. So there's actually two compartments with this. There is the front zip, which I will open for you guys and show you what's in there. And in here I just have some face charts if I get bored. And then I also just keep a hairdressing cape, but I keep it just in case. So for example, if I'm doing someone's makeup for the Melbourne Cup and they already have their dress and their hair and their fascinator already on, I don't want to get any powder or anything on that dress, especially if it's like Derby Day where they're wearing white or black or something that could really show up those particular colors. I make sure I use that, and that's just kind of a safeguard for me. Now, show for you guys, there's a lot of mesh pockets in this particular compartment of the bag. So you've got this big one here which I keep that cape, and then you also have three little compartments down here in the bottom. So for me, I just have the little inserts in one of them because, I mean, at the moment I don't need them, but in the future I might. And then in one of the other compartments, I just keep a few backup items. So for me, I have some brush wands because I don't want to be using my lipstick direct from the bullet on anybody's lips. I also have some spoolies for my mascaras and stuff like that, and for brow maintenance. And then I also have some Tatcha Japanese beauty papers, but they're essentially blotting sheets. So for someone like me who oils up so easily in my T-zone area, these are fantastic. So I've just got a packet of these sitting in the top compartment just in case I need them for a client. Okay, so just zipping that one back up. You could definitely fit so much more in that top compartment. Like, you could put eyeshadow palettes and stuff in there, but I feel like my travel case that I use for my regular kit carries everything fine, so I don't really need to at this stage. But it just means that there's room for me to grow down the track, which I really appreciate because I do want my kit to grow and develop. And I will be doing these kit videos annually just to see how my kit develops and grows over the years. So just opening the second compartment and just resting that there. So you guys might not be able to see, but I'll just pop it here like this. So literally the structure of this bag is quite simple. So this top pouch here is all mesh, and then it has a Velcro thing where you can remove it, and then you can put all your brushes in here. At the moment, I'm just holding some hair clips because I have a separate brush belt and I don't feel like I need to be using this at the moment. And then there's also a side zipper here where you can put palettes and stuff in the back, which is also super convenient. Now, this is all wipeable because it is a plastic here rather than being like a material, easy to keep clean. And this one hasn't been wiped, as you can see, and that's purely because I just haven't had the time to do so. Life's just been a little bit flat out at the moment, so I haven't done it. Now, in this front zipper, I keep a lot of my grab-and-go items. So for me, I've got my Q-tips in here, which is super important for so many different things. Like, you will be using these guaranteed. You can't not have them in your hygiene kit. I have a couple of puffs in here too. So I like to use these on my ring finger and then balance them on the face when I'm doing like the eyes and stuff like that. This one here I spilt foundation on. I've got to figure out how I'm going to get that out. I think I might need to use Sard, but this is just a Laura Mercier puff. Again, I use it through my fingers like that, and then I like to rest that on their face and then do their makeup. I just think, first of all, it's more professional, and second of all, it'll stop any movement of the makeup that you've already spent your time doing, so, I mean, why not? So I also have a packet of tissues here. I have a backup packet in the actual compartment as well. I just have like a little travel pack because, I mean, I can always just replace those as I need to. have another packet of lip wands in here, and then I also have another packet of my spoolies. You go through these like no tomorrow, so you can never have too many. I also keep some mints in here as well. I do not like to go to a set or any client without mints, because I like to eat food and I like to drink coffee, and I like to also get in the face of my client to make sure everything is perfect. I mean, I will be right in your face as a makeup artist. Like, I'm looking at every single detail, because how I like my makeup on me might not be the same as how a client might want their makeup. So based off their brief, I make sure that everything is as close to that as possible. And if I have to be right in your face, you're gonna need these. Okay, so now moving on into the main compartment of the bag. I'm not quite sure how much of it you guys can see, but I'll just grab things out and then show you the bag at the end. So I have baby wipes here. Like, literally, I couldn't see a client without baby wipes. Like, I smashed through these. And if you were to go out and buy like expensive makeup wipes, like the ones from MAC or something like that, you would be costing yourself so much money. So it's always good to have these on hand as your main way of keeping things clean and taking the makeup off your client if they don't like certain things, or keeping your hands clean, aside from hand sanitizer, of course. This is just a more cost-effective way of doing that. So definitely baby wipes. I also have nappy bags in here as well. So this is just a pack of 200, super cheap. You can just get them at your local Woolworths or your local Coles. Nothing too special. These are just put all of my rubbish in. I go through Q-tips, spoolies, and baby wipes like nothing else, and tissues as well, like, because I don't like to be messy. Every single time I touch a client or see a client, I like to clean up everything before I have somebody else come and sit down. So if I'm doing a bridal party, and then I'm going through each of the bridesmaids, and it might be a group of, say, I don't know, 8, and including the mother of the bride, I like to clean my station every single time before a new client comes and sits at my desk. So I put everything in one of these, and then at the end I just dispose of it. Super easy, nothing to it. Now I also keep 2 black towels in here. So I like to put a towel down just to make sure that I don't affect any surfaces that I may be working on, because a lot of the times I'll be at a wedding venue and I don't know, spill something that might get absorbed by the wood or by the laminate or anything like that, and then cause permanent damage with my makeup. Like, don't think that would figuratively happen, but just in case, I always like to have these to put down. And also, if I just need to wipe my brush off or something like that, it's better to wipe it off onto a black towel rather than a white towel, and then just show how messy things can get. Because look, let's get real, makeup gets super messy, and sometimes we have to disguise it a little bit with black towels. So I've got 2 just in case. Now, usually to go with the black towels, I like to carry some hand paper towel. So that kind of sits on top of the black towel. So this is like the first barrier of defense if I spill something or if I need to wipe something or whatnot. This is the first layer of defense, and then I kind of have the black towels. So this comes in super handy all the time, because if I'm going to do some spot cleaning on my brushes, I can just wipe it on this, which is straight on the surface where the towels are, and it's just super easy. I need to put some more in my kit very soon, but yeah, this works really well. Super inexpensive, just something to have on hand. I also have my cotton rounds. So I really don't have many left. These are by Swisper's, they're my favorite ones. They don't break apart. I find that some cotton rounds, if you get them like the cheap version, they literally break apart as you're using them, or they will have lint come off them, and it's just not a very good experience for you or the client. So I use the Swisper's ones, and these say soft and strong. So I don't know if there are different types or whatnot, but yeah, I've only got about like 10 left, so I definitely need to get a new packet. I want to get the massive ones. They're kind of like as big as like my powder puff. They're huge. I want to get a pack of those as well, because I think that they'd be really good for cleaning up the skin and giving them a little bit of a pamper session before starting the makeup application. And I just think the big ones are kind of like luxurious and like bougie, so I want to get some of those. But you definitely need them in your hygiene kit for sure. Speaking of like micellar water and stuff like that, I always keep a mini on hand. Literally, this stuff lasts forever. I had the jumbo bottle, but then it was taking up so much room in my hygiene kit that I was just like, why do I have this? So I went out and I bought a mini one, and I'm just going to fill it up as I need to. So this is just your standard Garnier Skin Naturals micellar cleansing water. So I use this to both remove makeup and to prep the skin before moisturizing. So I usually use this to make sure the skin is completely clear, and then I put moisturizer down and then I use primer and start with the foundations. So I think this is a really crucial step to both your hygiene and also the application of the makeup as well, because it really does set the precedence for what the makeup's gonna look like. And I mean, everybody knows what this is. There are so many different brands of micellar water on the market. This is just like a really inexpensive one. And if you can get a little travel version of it, it's so worth the investment. Okay, so the next thing I've got here is the MAC brush cleanser. So I could have gone for something a little bit cheaper, but I decided to go for the MAC one because it was just super accessible. MAC's super easy for me to get to. There's one just down the road from where I live, so I just go there. This smells nice. It looks cute. It's pink. I literally just pour some of this out onto the cotton rounds and then just spot clean my brushes as I need to. Like, this stuff is life changing. So I've got one for my kit. I want to get the Cinema Secrets, like the massive bottle, and then basically just fill, I'll just refill this up as I have to, because it's just a screw top lid and you can just put whatever you want in there. So I'll just continue to do that and then maybe put the Cinema Secret ones in here and then keep the big bottle for myself and my makeup collection at home. So this is definitely a good investment. A spot brush cleaner is so important for your hygiene kit, because you might find that if you're with a client, it could be either on set for a fashion shoot or it could be like doing a wedding party, you might not actually have enough brushes to cover all of your clients that you're dealing with that day. So for example, if you're doing a bridal party of, say, I don't know, 10, you might not have enough blending brushes in your kit to service all 10, especially if some of them might have very similar eye shapes and then you might need the same brush on multiple occasions. You will need to clean them. And sometimes you don't have time to be going to the bathroom and cleaning all of your brushes with soap and all that sort of stuff. This stuff just honestly cuts it in half and it's dry. So like as soon as you've cleaned it, they're dry. This won't completely clean your brushes. This is not a replacement for doing the proper process for cleaning your brushes, but it will get you through with your clients on the day. So definitely make sure you've got this in your hygiene kit. And then I also have the Nivea Daily Essentials 24-Hour Moisture Boost Refresh Protecting Day Cream. Now this is my moisturizer of choice. So I chose this one because literally I know that I have the most sensitive skin out there. Like, the slightest thing will make me break out. And that's not what you want for a bride, especially if they're going on a honeymoon very soon after and they're going to want to be taking photos and stuff. You want a moisturizer that is not going to clash with their skincare routine. This one has quite good ingredients in it. I can't say enough good things about it. My skin doesn't react with this. My skin doesn't oil up with this. Again, personal preference, but I know that I've had my skin tested and I've been told that I have quite temperamental skin. This is quite a neutral moisturizer. So you could use this on people with dry skin and you can use it on people with oily skin. Somebody who has particularly dry skin might need some additional help. So you might need to, I don't know, give them a serum, or they may have a preference for what kind of moisturizer or prepping kind of cream that they want to be using. But I definitely recommend this one. It's definitely a good investment to have a really good quality moisturizer in your hygiene kit. Now, I also have a little baggie inside my bag. Bag inside my bag. Okay. Now, this has a few bits and bobs in here that are quite important. So I have some extra Q-tips in here and some extra brush spoolies just in case. They're usually kept in there for my makeup classes more than anything else. I would always get a fresh one out for a client, but they're more or less just for me. I also keep a lip balm in there as well. So this is the Dermal Therapy lip balm. This is an intensive lip balm and I honestly couldn't say enough great things about it. Super inexpensive. It's about $5 from Priceline. Love it. Like, incredible. Now I've got hand sanitizer in here as well, just a travel size. You must have hand sanitizer. Every single time you touch something that's not sterilized by yourself within your kit, you must wash your hands. Every single time you, say for example, if you were to say, be doing someone's makeup and then, I don't know, I was to grab my Pepsi, I've now touched a contaminated surface. So I would need to go back into my hand sanitizer, clean my hands, and then touch my makeup products and touch the person's face. You want to ensure that the client knows that you are hygienic and that you are sticking to the minimum standards of cleanliness. minimum standards of cleanliness. Like, you are in their face, you are touching their face, you are right up near everything. So hygiene is key. Make sure you have a hand sanitizer. This one is antibacterial, ultra hydrating with enriched 4 moisturizers, and kills 99.99% of germs fast. I got it because it was pink. I mean, duh. So, I mean, you can kind of see a theme with me liking pink. But anyway, got one of those. Also in here I also keep my palette and my spatula in here as well. So every single time I use a cream product or something like that, I decant it and I put it onto my palette. So this one's from MAC. I bought the palette from them and then I also bought the spatula from them. It was a bit expensive in terms of what it was. I know that you can get cheaper versions of this either on eBay or from Daiso or whatnot. This was like, I think these two together were about $60. But I mean, they're from MAC. Again, MAC is just a super convenient location for me to get everything. So that's why I go there. That's why I got my stuff from there. You can do it cheaper, but I mean, you just got to do what works for you. So this is super important because you don't want to be using stuff straight out of the palette on the person's face. You don't want to be using your fingers. You don't want to be using the back of a brush. You want to be using the proper tools. So that sits in there as well. Next up in there, I have a bunch of individual lashes. I don't really know why they're sitting in there, but I also have a set of lashes that are just sitting in my kit as well. So these two kind of just float around in there together just in case. I mean, they're fully exposed. They're probably a little bit damaged, but I've also got the Socialize Minx 2.0 lashes. Yeah, got those in there as well. I also have an extra hair clip, which belongs up in there. But anyway, I also keep my eyelash curlers. These are some rose gold eyelash curlers that I got when I was over in England. I just got them from Boots. They're nothing really ride or die or special. They do the job. I do want to invest in the Shiseido ones, I'm pretty sure, or the Lily Lashes matte black ones that she has. They look so good. So I might treat myself to some of those when I have officially finished my course, or maybe when I reach 1,000 subscribers on YouTube. We're actually not that far away, which is so cool. Oh my god, I can't believe it. Like, that is so much more than I ever expected. Like, thank you, thank you, thank you for subscribing to my channel. But maybe I'll make that my treat to myself for reaching 1,000 subscribers one day. So I have a few other bits in that pouch. I have 2 mascaras in here. I have the MAC Extended Play Giga Black Lash, and I also have a sample of the Lights Camera Lashes by Tarte. So I have these 2. Now these are what I dip into with the little spoolies here, the little brush spoolies. So I don't ever, ever, ever grab this and put that directly on my client's eyes. So I also have one for myself. I love this for my lower lash line. I'm pretty sure the one that I use on myself is expired, but this one's new. So that one's fine. And it also works a lot better than my one. And then this one, again, like, I just pop the spoolies in the end of this, and then it's pretty much the same kind of shape as what's on this. The only time that I would ever use one of these on a client, like directly, is if it's brand new and I intended on giving it to them. But otherwise, always use one of your spoolie brushes. Okay, so I also have the Ilua lash adhesive. This is latex free and it's clear. I had the worst experience with some latex eyelash glue. My eyes react like nothing else. So in my bad experience, I'm now 100% behind being latex free no matter what, and this stuff by Ilua lasts all day. So I definitely recommend this stuff. I wouldn't say super inexpensive, but it does only last 6 months, so you do need to be aware of that. So make sure you are rotating out your eyelash glues consistently. They go really, really close to the eyes. Like, they're on the other side of the eyelashes, but they're still quite close and they can cause irritation. So definitely keep an eye on that. Make sure you've got a good quality one, and also make sure it is always in date. Okay, so I've got the last few tools left in my little pouch. So I've got a pair of tweezers, which I sanitize with alcohol after every single use and before every single use. I also have a pair of scissors in here as well. I either use to cut my lashes, or if I have to cut away flyaways, you'd be surprised how much you're going to need these. And then I also have a pencil sharpener for my eyeliners and my lip pencils and stuff like that. So again, these get sanitized consistently. I do know that something that's not in my kit right now, and I'm not quite sure where it is spraying alcohol. So you literally need to spray everything down after every single use to make sure that it is sanitized. You can use spray alcohol on pans, so it won't actually hard pan them. It will just sanitize the top layer. An alternative is you can get a cotton round, just like we were talking about before. You can rub the top layer off and that again sanitizes it as well. So hygiene is key when working as a makeup artist. You must ensure that you are super hygienic because, again, like I've said, you are right in the client's face and they're gonna be watching the way that you conduct yourself when you're doing their makeup. And if you're not being hygienic, they're gonna know, they're gonna see it, and they're not gonna recommend you to their friends. Basically, the core of your artistry beyond just your application skills is your hygiene. So I cannot stress this enough that if you are getting into makeup artistry or you're thinking about getting into makeup artistry and making that leap or having a career change or whatnot, make sure you have your head around the fact that hygiene is a part of it and it is an expense as well. So these things must always be replenished. You cannot go on set without this stuff as a minimum. Like sometimes I even go on set with Glen 20 spray and I spray everything down first just because you don't know what's going on. You don't know who's been there. You don't know what's happening. So it's just best to be super hygienic rather than not display any of those hygienic practices and then look like you're a dirty person. And then you're putting makeup on clients and they're thinking that your makeup's dirty. Like, nah, honey, no. Okay, so I will show you guys my bag now. So this is the Atoll medium size bag. So this is the carry bag. Now, some people use this just for, I don't know, if they're traveling or something like that, and they just put their makeup and their hair care and stuff in there. You can put little inserts in here and break it up. There's like little grooves in the top up here, and then you can put your plastic inserts into it. I have just opted not to do that because it's easier for me to pop everything into this bag if it's just left open. So like, I might eventually change this. I might move a few things around in my bigger travel case so that I can have a hygiene section just for this sort of stuff. But for now, this sits on top of my makeup travel case and it just works for me. It's just easy because I know where everything is. I have my immediate go-to stuff here. I have my other bits and bobs here. And then if I need to get some extra brush space, it'll just go under here. But for now, I've got my clips in there. So it's just easy for me to work with. And if I was to go traveling overseas or something and I needed something like this to come with me, I just empty everything out and take it. So if you haven't had a chance to check out this brand, it's Atoll Collective. This video is not sponsored or anything like that. I mean, I have a really small following, so why would it be sponsored? This is a great, great brand. Super high quality. This stuff is like mesh, like plasticky and meshy. So it's really, really easy to keep clean. It doesn't get dirty. I mean, obviously if you're gonna spill foundation all over it, it's gonna get dirty, but it's really easy to clean up. So I definitely recommend this as a hygiene kit, as a makeup kit, as a stage bag, like whatever works for you. This is definitely a multi-use bag and it's worth the investment. So that's everything from me, guys. I hope you really enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you give it a big thumbs up and let me know in the comments below. If you like the makeup I'm wearing at the moment, I do have a tutorial on this makeup on my channel as well. I will have it linked in the description box below. So again, do not forget to go and check me out on Instagram as well if you are interested in seeing some of the photos of my makeup artistry work. And I'm pretty sure that's everything from me, and I will see you guys in my next video. Thanks, guys. Bye.